Hello everybody. Today I'm going to show you how to ingest data from SAP SuccessFactors using Azure Data Factory. The first thing I will be doing is to show you how to connect to a table in SAP SuccessFactors using REST via Postman, and I will be replicating these steps in Azure Data Factory. The first thing you will be needing is some information on how to connect to SAP SuccessFactors. I got these three steps from my admin, and I'm going to show you how I set it up in Postman. So for the first step, I got a URL, and I got some body parameters I need to pass in. So I've done it here. So I'm just sending this request. In response, I get this response that I need for my step two. Step two is set up as this. You have a post URL and some other information you need, and then you're pasting in the response from the last request here. This will in return give you some an access token that will expire in, I think it's 9 hours. The next step is used to specify which table you want to retrieve. So here I'm retrieving the user table, and I'm just pasting in the access token. The result here should then represent all the rows for the user table. So let's head over to Azure Data Factory and do the same. So these three boxes, or the activities, represent the three steps I did in Postman. These first two are called web activities, which can be found here. I just drag it in, configure it with the URL and the method, and so on. You'll see here I've specified the URL, the post method, and then the body parameters here. I've concatenated the values, so you'll see the client ID, the first parameter here, all over here, and then using the and sign, oops, then specifying the next parameter, and so on. Important to note that that's the header section where you specify this is being URL encoded. For the next step, it's very similar. The only difference is that this one actually relies on some data from the previous field. So here I'm specifying I need the output from the last activity and get the information from the response field. I'm saying the response field because that is actually where this long string is located that I need. So I debug this pipeline. And when I debug it, I can actually see the output and input for all of these activities. For the first one, going here, and then I can see this long string that I need is actually located in the response field. So that's why it's taken from the response field. And in the first step, I'm using a copy activity, which can be found here. Just drag it in and configure it. Where it is used to turn the JSON output and save it into a JSON file on my data lake. I'm specifying the source here. So the endpoint for retrieving the table consists of it should look like this value here, or this string here. So I split it into a static string here, the first, the URL, and then appending the dynamic part, this one, building it here. Looks like this, where this one will be changed with a parameter at runtime. So basically this one will be replaced with user when we run it. For the header session, we have to pass in the access token from the step before. And that's how I do it this way. And with this, I should actually be able to run my pipeline. So I'm running the first one, and this one gives me the response that I need. Passing it to the next activity. Then this one gives me the access token. Cool, it's finished. And then I'm saving the response as a JSON file in my blob storage or my data lake. Let's see if it's there. Cool. So this is the latest file. Let's have a look. So this is the response we got from the REST endpoint. I think let's explore how to flatten this output and turn it into some table data in the next video.